Hello, my name is Nick Davis. I'm a realtor with RE/MAX Premier Group, and I live and work here in the Tampa Bay area. Today, what we're going to talk about are the most common contingencies involved in a real estate transaction. Number one, on the buying side, typically there will be an inspection contingency. Now, this can vary from contract to contract, from state to state. What we're going to be talking about is the Florida Association of Realtors as-is contract to start off with. When you go under contract to purchase a home and have a inspection contingency on the FAR bar as is, you get to choose an inspector. You can do the inspection yourself, and normally you'll have anywhere from 0 to 15 days to do this home inspection. And the Florida as is contract says that if the buyer determines in the buyer's sole discretion that the property is not acceptable to the buyer, that they can deliver written notice of cancellation of the contract to the seller. And provided that you do this during that inspection contingency, then all escrow monies would be returned to you, the buyer, and you would be released from all further obligations of the contract. Now, on the Florida FAR contract, you have to use a licensed inspector, and you will have anywhere from 0 to 15 days. Now, the difference between these two contracts is that on the FAR contract, there is an allowance that the seller will agree to pay for warranted items that's usually negotiated during the negotiation phase of the contract. And standard, it's 1.5% of the purchase price towards warranted items. However, that can be adjusted to whatever numbers you and the seller agreed to. A big misconception is that it's an as-is contract. Well, it is. However, you can also ask for repairs to be done. Now, when I talk about repairs, I'm not talking about like ceiling caulk or cosmetic issues. I'm talking about warranted items. And let's just say, for example, you do a home inspection and the air conditioner isn't working. Well, if the seller does nothing with that air conditioner, it's going to affect every offer down the road. So as a buyer, you can go back to the seller and say, okay, I will still purchase the home at this price, but I want these items repaired. Now, the seller can accept that and they'd sign the addendum and move forward. They can come back and say, well, I'll fix this, but I'm not going to fix that. Then it's up to you to decide whether you want to continue moving forward. Or they can just say, no, it's an as-is contract and I'm not fixing anything. Again, you'll have a choice then. You can accept it. You'd be able to cancel the contract and get your earnest money back, provided that everything was done in accordance with the contract and during the specified time frames. Number two is a financing contingency. If you're doing a mortgage, you will have a financing contingency. Some mortgages have specific addendums that have to be attached to the contract. Like, for instance, an FHA or a VA loan, you have to have that addendum attached to the contract. There's specific language associated with each of those two different types of loans. One of the most common things we see is that a lot of realtors don't include an appraisal addendum with a conventional mortgage. And they say, well, it's covered in the contract. Well, it is and it isn't. So as a rule of thumb, if we're doing a conventional mortgage, we always encourage our buyers to include an appraisal addendum, which says that the home has to appraise at the contract price in order for you to continue with the purchase. And I'll give you an example. Let's just say you were purchasing a home for $200,000 and you were putting 20% down. That would be $40,000. So your loan amount is only $160,000. And so let's just say the house appraised at $195,000. Well, you may still be qualified to purchase and have to pay that additional $5,000 to the seller at closing. But if an appraisal addendum was included in the offer, that would protect you 100%. You'd be able to renegotiate with the seller. You'd be able to cancel the contract if you wanted to and get your earnest money back. It's just an added layer of protection. One of the most common contingencies for a buyer if they are purchasing a new home could be that they have to sell their home in order to purchase the home here. So having that contingency definitely will ensure that you are protected. Now, we've been talking about mostly buyer contingencies, but there are contingencies on the seller side. Ownership. The title company is going to do a title search and exam. Here in Florida, they go all the way back to when the property was just dirt, and they will ensure that there are no liens or encumbrances or anything that can cloud the title and affect your ownership or allow someone to come back later and say, hey, I did some work on this house and I never was paid. That's what title insurance is for and how it protects you. Normally, with the Florida contracts, the owner selects the title company and pays for the owner's policy. And there's some other fees and charges that are associated with that that the seller picks up. All right, I've got a few tips for you. If all contingencies are not met, either party can back out of the deal. Now, saying that, we have to ensure that you met all the requirements and you did everything within the specified times of the contract. We want to ensure that you are in accordance with that contract so that there's no question if one of these contingencies had to be used. Tip number two, the fewer contingencies that you have as a buyer when submitting an offer, the cleaner the offer is going to look. Now, I'm not saying don't have an inspection contingency or don't have a financing contingency. That wouldn't be a wise decision for you to make. However, when you get into multiple offers and you're trying to find the home of your dreams, sometimes you may have to remove a contingency. Or one of the things we like to do is reduce the amount of time. For example, I told you earlier that an inspection contingency is usually 0 to 15 days, and 15 days is the default number on the contract. So what we may do is say we will get the inspection done within 7 days. Makes it a little bit quicker, and sometimes that could be the difference in your offer being accepted, because if there was an issue, the house would be able to go back on the market relatively quick as opposed to waiting the full 15 days with another offer. I know that was kind of quick, but we didn't want to make a long video because your lender is going to go over all these things with you. Our job is to ensure that you are protected throughout your purchase, and that if there is a contingency that we included in our offer. If you're interested in finding out more and working with Team Davis to help you find your new home here in the Tampa Bay area, give us a call, 813-300-7116. Please do me a favor, hit the subscribe button with notifications turned on. This way, anytime we make a new video, you'll get notified immediately. Talk to you soon.